In this video, we shall discuss how to work with pivot data. Before we begin, we have to make some preparations. We shall need such a table in all three DBMSs. And about each shopping, we shall store the ID of that shopping, the transaction ID, and the product category. When we fill this table with data, we shall see the following picture. Here we see shopping IDs, and those IDs are unique. Here we see transaction IDs, and those IDs are not unique. And here we see product categories. The main idea here is that some items were purchased together and some items were purchased on their own. Now we may proceed with tasks, and in the first one we have to show as a pivot table how many times customers purchased products of a certain category together with products of other categories. And here is the expected result. These numbers on the main diagonal may be inaccurate here, but those numbers are not of interest here. We only need all other numbers in this table. The basic idea for this solution is that first we have to get the duplicated Cartesian product for all transactions, as we have to produce such a temporary table. Then we have to take the duplicated again each element from this column, here it is, and count each element from this column occurrence, here it is. And that's how we make our pivoted data. Let's start with MySQL. In this common table expression, we produce this deduplicated Cartesian product. As you remember, MySQL does not support full outer join, that's why we need left outer join, right outer join, and union here. Now we have a trouble. MySQL does not support pivot tables, but nevertheless we may use count function to simulate the tables. Here we are taking each element from this column, here it is, and we count each element from this column occurrence, this is how we do it. And finally we are grouping the results by this column, and that's how we get our pivoted data. Yet there is another trouble. All these categories' names are static here. But if we want dynamic columns, as dynamic category names, we have to follow this approach. First, we have to produce that query section with a lot of count function calls. And we put the result into this variable. Then we have to take the query from the previous solution, put that section here, and execute that query. And that's how we get our final result. In Microsoft SQL Server, the solution for static columns is easy. First, we have to produce that deduplicated Cartesian product, and in Microsoft SQL Server, we have full outer join. Because Microsoft SQL Server supports pivoted tables, on this step we may use such syntax to produce the final result immediately. But still, these names of product categories are static here in this solution. If we want to make the solution for dynamic columns in Microsoft SQL Server, first we have to produce the list of that columns. Then we have to prepare the query we've already seen on the previous slide, putting that column's names there, and then we have to execute the query. And that's how we get our final result. In Oracle, the solution for static columns is exactly the same as in Microsoft SQL Server. Here we use full outer join to produce that deduplicated Cartesian product, and then we use pivot function to immediately produce the final result. Still, of course, those categories' names are static here also. If we want to make the solution for Oracle with dynamic columns, there's a bad surprise waiting for us. Oracle does not provide a simple way to execute a dynamic query with variables except from within a stored routine. But nevertheless, you may create such a stored routine yourself and produce that solution. In the second task, we have to show as a pivot table the number and the percentage of times each product was bought on itself and along with other products. This is how the expected result looks like. Here, for each category, we see that category name, then the number of times products of that category were bought with products of other categories, and the number of times products of that category were bought in single mode, as without any product of any other category. Finally, these columns are produced via mathematical calculations based on those values. The basic idea for this solution is the next. First, we have to determine all transactions types. It asked for each transaction we have to calculate how many categories of products were in this transaction. If there was only one product category, that's the single transaction. Otherwise, it's a multi-transaction. Then we use these transactions types to determine if a product was bought on itself or along with other products of other categories. Here is the result. You see that for each and every item we see the type of the transaction. And finally, we have to count multi and single occurrences for each item, deduplicated. And here is the result. In the solution for MySQL, in the first common table expression, we use such query to produce that data. Then in the second common table expression, we use that data and such query to produce this data. In the final common table expression, we use count function to produce that data. And this count function usage was explained in details in the first solution. Finally, knowing these numbers, we may easily calculate their percentage, and that's how we get our final result. The first part of the solution for Microsoft SQL Server is exactly the same. In the first common table expression, we use such query to produce this data. Then in the second common table expression, we use this query to produce that data. In the second part, in the final common table expression, we may use pivot function to produce that data. And finally, we use mathematical calculations to produce the percentage of these numbers. And the solution for Oracle is exactly the same as it is for Microsoft SQL Server. Here, in the first common table expression, we detect the transaction types and produce such data. Then in the second common table expression we use that data and such query to produce that data. In the final common table expression we use pivot function to produce that data. Finally we use mathematical calculations to produce the percentage of these numbers. In the last task we are returning to our library database. Here we have to show as a pivot table the number of books taken from the library in each month of each year. But the information about months we should arrange horizontally and information about years we should arrange vertically. This is how the expected result looks like. Here we see months horizontally, years vertically. The basic idea for this solution is that first we have to count subscriptions by each year and month, and this is the result. Then we only have to transform this data into pivot form. In MySQL, the first part is that easy. This query produces that data. And in the second part, we have to use some function to simulate pivoting. The idea here is exactly the same as in the first solution when we were using count function for the same reason. In Microsoft SQL Server, this part is exactly the same as in MySQL. Here we produce that data. Then we may easily use pivot function to produce pivoted data. But all these nulls should not be here, they have to be replaced with zeros. And we are performing that replacement here in this final part of the query. The solution for Oracle is exactly the same as the solution for Microsoft SQL Server is. First we produce this data, then we use pivot function to produce the pivoted data. Finally, we have to replace nulls with zeros, and we achieve that using NVL function here in this part of the query.